Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today you can see we got the Mitsubishi Zero. Now we've already done the display stand, you saw that working perfectly. This is the aircraft now. We got the wings to fit, or the top parts of the wings. There we go, looking beautiful. We got the drop tank and the bombs, and also our pilot. There he is. He can just sit in his seat. Then all we have to do after that is add the cannon extenders. What else was the? Well, yes, the fuselage parts up here. There's a little piece for here. We've got all the decals. There we go. I think we got spurs here as well. The decals, you can't actually see them. Here we go. This is stage 94. Got the cannon extenders in and that fuselage top as well. Excellent stuff. Now that will look absolutely brilliant. Now I know for a fact the plane is fully functioning independently because I've tested it with the motors. Everything is hunky-dory, but there was one issue, and it was a major issue for me anyway. It was a power issue, nothing to do with the aircraft. The display base, as you saw, worked like a treat, but as soon as I put the aircraft on it, a problem arose, and here it is. Hi all, it's John Model Maker here. Welcome to my channel. As you can see, I've got the Mitsubishi Zero Fighter on its stand. Now, as you can see, I've stripped it right back simply because I had a power issue. The power connector they sent me in issue 85 was actually wired up incorrectly. There are two cables which go up the shaft onto the PCB via the socket from the PCB on the base. As you can imagine, it's a 5-pin socket. Pin 3 isn't used, but mine was wired up incorrectly because somebody had soldered one of the cables onto pin 3, so it didn't fully work. It would rise, it would bank, it would bank left and bank right, but there was no sound effects, no lighting, no cannons, no guns. It just didn't do what it's supposed to do. So I contacted Agora and they passed me on to Mark, the master modeler on the Agora forum. I told him exactly what the problem was and what I thought it was, it being wired incorrectly. He checked his, confirmed that is the problem. I've resoldered the connections today, matched it all up, and now you'll see the result. So switch it on and it should rise and fall. Okay. Let's have it around here for you. That's a bit better, isn't it? There we go. Hold that. Okay, okay. We'll have the engine start. Take off. Cannons. Lights. Brilliant. Banking. And again. And now we can have it landing. Perfect. Now I know the ailerons work and the elevators work. I'm sure the rudder works. I've just got to check the flaps to see if they're working. That's something I haven't looked at. They should come down when it's landing. but my understanding is because they have brakes. But anyway, as you can see, it is working brilliantly. I didn't have any of that previously. Roll the lights off. There we go. And you can see the landing gear is perfectly synchronized. So that's brilliant as well, because I know there was an issue with some modelers, and we actually added a clear washer under one of the screws so as it would actually trigger the switch. So that model works perfectly. So anyway, that is that for now. All I need to do is put it all back together, and everything should be hunky-dory. But I do need to check the flaps. But anyway, I'm really chuffed about that. That's brilliant. Absolutely loving it. See you soon. Bye for now. Hi all, welcome back to the Mitsubishi. Well, I hope you enjoyed that where the power fault was concerned. There was an issue with the flaps. There's a cog on the end of the motor and that was sometimes slipping. So basically I took the cog off, popped some super glue on the end of it, put the cog on, and it's brilliant. It works fantastic. It doesn't slip at all now, so that's great. Other than that, there was no issues basically. The rudder was working fine, the rear landing wheel was fine, the elevator's fine, the ailerons are fine, and now the flaps are working perfectly all right. So all that remains to do is carry on with this build with issue 94 and fit these wing panels on both sides. So let's get on with the build. So there we go, that's what we've got. Stage 94. Got the decals, or some of them anyway, we've already got some. And here we have pitot tubes, cannon extenders, and antenna. And we have this panel. Those are the cover panels for the wings. And this one goes on the vertical stabilizer there at the back. So let's see. First thing we need to do is to pop this in place. There we go. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 holes, and this should hopefully fit in there like that. I think that's in. That looks great. And then we have this little piece which goes just here, just like that. That looks brilliant already. Fantastic stuff. And there we have the cannons and the pitot tube. The pitot tube goes in there like that. Basically the cannon extender has a rubber part there which you actually slot along. You push the cannon into place like that, and then this rubber piece goes to the back there. So just bend the plastic frame down and push that into place. Stops any light bleed, I suppose. And that is the cannon in place. Just the same as that one. Okay, now we need to put this top wing in place. Make sure you don't get any wires trapped. Dress them around these points, because that point, there's 9 points of connection. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I think I've counted 10 there, but there's only 9 on the actual underneath here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There we go. Yeah, now. It's essential you don't get any wires caught whatsoever. And then we can put the top of the wing on. There we go, that's the wing on top. It is a very, very tight fit pushing it in, but we got 1, 2 screws. Does look the part though. That should pop up there. Lock it up, now we can do the other side. Again, make sure no cables like this one are in the way. There we go. Keep them dressed out of the way and everything should be hunky-dory. And we can pop it in place. Very tight fit. There we go. Seems to have clicked in place. Click your little head off. Sorry, shake that. There we go. Now we just need to get the screws. Okay, that's the two wing tops in place. This one was a real toughie. This one was pretty straightforward, but this one was really tight. But it's nicely in place now. Like I said, one, two, three, four screws, two on each wing. That's perfect now. All we need to do now is to fit these panels. That one can go there. And that one can go there. They're a relatively loose fit. You might want to glue them, but I wouldn't if I were you, because you just never know sometimes. And then we've got some other little pieces to fit. We have one for here. There we go, them's the two screw covers. That one is a little bit looser than that one, but they're not going to come off anyway, so that's great. We now have two aileron control rods. There you can see them, palm of my hand, and they fit here and just here, and these little two slots, so I'll just get them in place. I will be gluing these two in because they are very loose fit. Next we have the antenna, which goes just in here, drop it down, there we go, and it should lean towards the canopy, towards the front. That's brilliant. And there you can see the aileron control rod pointing to the rear. Excellent. And what we can do next, we can put our pilot in place. So we'll move that strap. There he is, sat in his canopy. Oh, you can't see from there. There we go. Excellent stuff. Now there's a better close-up shot where we can shut the canopy. Excellent stuff. Brilliant. I think that's all that's left to do now is to put the decals on, the drop tank and the bombs. Okay, all that's left to do at this stage is to put the drop tank in place, as well as the bombs. They do go on one way. There you go. They just push into place. I think that is on the other side. Yep. And that one is for here. There we go, like that. And then the drop tank. Oops, so there's a little panels come off the top. Well, I knew they were loose anyway. Let's see, that one goes. It's only the screw cover. There we go. That's the bombs in the drop tank in place. This is quite a mini. That little panel came off there. I think I might have to just tag that in. I'm not going to super glue anything down because you just never know with these aircraft. But that is now ready for a test. Okay, let's give it a little test run. I've set the cameras up so they can capture as much as possible. Switch it on the side. It will rise up and down. You'll hear one or two clicks. It's just resetting itself. There we go. Rear landing wheel has come up. I'll pop the lights on. There we go. Lights on in the cockpit as well. These are the machine guns. The cannons. Let's see, bank left. Back right. You see the ailerons come into play. Now we can land it. Excellent. Flaps working, everything's working. That is absolutely brilliant. Excellent stuff. Well, there she is, folks. That is that complete. All I need to do now is put the decals on, but I'm not doing that today, simply because I want to give it a little test or two. Everything is working perfect. You just got to watch out for the pitot tube because you can easily break that. Same with the cannons as well, because obviously they're quite lengthy. These top panels, very difficult getting them in place. Once you get them in place, well, it's, you try and get them out of place afterwards. It's looking absolutely superb. Everything's working. Flaps, ailerons, rudder, the rear landing wheel, everything is great. Now, I know it's not got as much functionality as the Spitfire, and the Spitfire is working perfectly good. But it's not got any gapping issues, and that's a major thing. There's no gapping issues whatsoever, so I'm really chuffed with it. I really am. So I'll give it a once over again afterwards, make sure I've not missed anything, which I don't think I have. You can even take this cowling off to show off the radial engine, which is absolutely brilliant. No major problems. I'm going to put some green bays on here as well. So once I've done the decals and I'll put some green bays on here, because it is an ugly grey colour, that should make it stand out a little bit more as well. But anyway, that is excellent. I hope you did enjoy that, because I certainly didn't, like a big kid again. Anyway, I do love my aircraft, I must admit. You can see them in the background there. There's the Mark II Spitfire, the Bristol, there we go, the Bristol Blenheim, and the Hawker Hurricane Mark I. I will be doing the Sterling Mark IV on my channel. It won't be on very soon, because it'll take me some time to get that done anyway. You've got to take your time with these plastic models, because the Mark II over there, I had a problem with the decals. They split and it caused all sorts of problems. But it was my fault, because I should have put the round nose on first, but I put everything else on except the underwing round nose, and it caused me no end of problems repainting. Ugh. Anyway, I learned my lesson on that one. But I really do love this. It's a cracking buy. It really does look the part, and it's going to sit alongside the Spitfire. So the Spitfire don't behave, it can shoot it. Anyway, thanks again for watching. Give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you soon. Thanks again, bye for now.